What's up, guys? Welcome back to Cybo TV. My name is Alex.
And I'm Adam.
And this is Subway Surfers Versus, the show where Adam and I face off in Subway Surfers. The rules are simple. We've got 10 minutes, 3 hoverboards, and no boosters, and we see who can get the highest score possible. So, let's get right into it.
Let's do it. But first, a little message for you guys to say that if you love creating artwork, you now have your chance to make your very own Subway Surfers merchandise over at Redbubble. You can create anything from t-shirts, coffee cups, phone cases, and all sorts of cool things like that. You even have a little opportunity to make some money off of it. So go check it out and get your creative mind spinning. Who are you going to be playing as this round?
So for this round, I'm going to be playing as Rabot, our Easter special. And to go with her awesome pink colors, I've chosen the bubblegum board.
Nice.
That's also nice cool. And pink.
Well, in the last round, we were talking about invoking the powers of Thor to help me speed along. And unfortunately, I realized why that didn't quite work out for me last time. This time, I'm going to be surfing as Bjarki in his power outfit. So he's going to be training very strong, muscular.
Mm-hmm.
And he's going to be surfing on Thor's hammer, the Copenhagen board, which is what I didn't do last time. So we're going to be using the powers of lightning to whoop your ass.
All right.
I hope you guys are ready for this one because I need to regain my honor in this third round.
Challenge accepted.
Otherwise, it's a hat trick from Alex. Are you ready?
This is technology versus mythology.
That's, well, exactly.
So.
Three.
Whoa, hold up. Three,
two one.
Boop.
Oh, go. I didn't register on the screen there.
Yeah, so much for the power of Thor.
But it means I lose half a second, but don't worry, guys. It's half a second is nothing when it comes to how much I'm going to be beating Alex by in
right.
this round.
Oh, whoa, I almost crashed there. Hold on.
It's not looking good for Alex already. It's not looking good already.
I'm going to take this dub, man. I'm going to take this dub. Whoa, I almost crashed again.
We are at the slowest point in the game. Alex has almost crashed twice. This is really working out for me already, guys. The power of Thor compels you. The power of Thor compels
Hey, look, I'm just used to really high speeds and some high-paced action, man. That's like, that's all. This is
that's
too slow for my liking.
That's what it is. To be fair, I almost just, I didn't crash, but I almost had the guard catch me. So.
It's like when you spend as much time like at racing at higher speeds as we do, it's almost unsettling running at the slowest pace. It's like it's almost harder to time things because we're so used to something else.
Yeah, it almost sounds snobbish the way you're
saying. Almost sounds like a humble brag. It was like, yeah, you know, like. Doing that slow run is like almost more difficult than doing the fast run, you know, because we're fast all the time.
Playing in the beginner series is just, you know, not worth our time anymore because, you know, we're just pros, we're used to that.
Hey, we're still human, guys. As you can tell from our many crashes and failures and me almost crashing within the first like 30 seconds of this round.
Exactly.
So.
Alrighty. Well, I'm not doing so bad with power-ups. I haven't seen any jetpacks for a while, though.
Are you
in a jetpack yet? I've got a double score multiplier, but my jetpack finding abilities have been a bit limited. Oh, speaking of, I'm at a double score multiplier. Yes, please.
God damn it.
That will shoot me ahead.
You know what? I'm not even going to listen to that. I'm just going to focus on the beautiful surroundings because
You focus on the scenic route that you're taking.
Oh, well, okay. I've got a jetpack now. So I was going to say that I saw a bunch of sheep, which might be the family that Bjarki has his little sheep buddy from. So, you know, if you at any point want to, you know, just stop by and pay them a visit,
Hang on a minute. You were playing as Bjarki the past two rounds, weren't you?
I was.
And you're saying there's a whole horde of sheep in this level?
There is.
I think I know what's gone in here. I think the sheep were playing against me the last two rounds, guys. I think that's what it was. Alex was playing as Bjarki. Everyone knows Bjarki looks after the sheep in Iceland. And so
I think they were against me.
I think they were probably tugging at my hoverboard and sabotaging it and things like that.
You think they were infiltrating your game data?
That's what I think was happening. But now I missed a power up. God damn it! But now I'm Bjarki, so the sheep should be on my team. And yeah. I've got Thor's hammer hoverboard, which I'm gonna implement now. Woo! Okay, that was lucky. All right, Thor.
Oh, well, I just got a double score multiplier into a pogo stick into a jetpack. So, you know
nice.
What? Well, you just keep cruising on Thor's hammer. I'm just going to be on
hang
my
on. How did you get a double score multiplier and a jetpack and a pogo stick all at the same time? That's got to be not. That's got to be not possible. How? Surely.
I was just back to back. You know, it's just one of my little secrets.
All right, come on, Chris. Chris Hemsworth, send me the powers of Thor.
You're still on about that? Oh, well, there you go. There's another jetpack right after I finish my first one.
Well, thankfully, I also just picked up a jetpack right on the end of my other double score multiplier.
Oh, darn.
Let's hope this helps.
What's your score now?
I'm not going to tell you. I'm going to keep it secret, and then you can find out right at the end just how badly you've lost. So that's how it's going to work.
All right, well, I'm just going to, you know, unnerve you a little bit. I just passed 310,000 points. And I've got 3,160 points.
Oh dear. Oh dear, guys.
Yeah, I know.
I'm calling your bluff. It looks like Alex has some work to do to catch up with us here.
I'm calling your bluff, Adam.
You can call whatever you want, mate. The guys at home know what's really going on.
No. Please not.
Please don't do this.
Please not do this. Yeah, I feel like I'm getting emotionally attached to all these animals that we're seeing in the level. Like the puffins, especially the seals. I was cool with the sheep, but since you're with Bjarke now, I mean, I guess that's more.
Do you have any pets at home?
I used to have a dog. He was very cute.
So if you could take home any of these animals as a pet at home, which one would you have and why? Out of all the ones you've seen in this level?
If I could, I would take
the sheep.
If I could, I would take the seals because they're, I don't know, they're adorable, man. Have you ever heard seals like make noises? They go like, bluff, bluff.
Sorry, what do they say?
Something like, bluff, bluff.
I didn't quite catch that again. Chloe, could you just repeat that online for everyone?
Just one more time. You want to hear it one more time?
I think everyone online just wants to see you do a seal.
Yeah, some like.
All right. Well, you know what? Full respect for you actually doing the impression three times in a row. I thought you were gonna get embarrassed, but you didn't. Well done.
Hey, man, I'm committed. I'm committed to the egg. Plus, I've done way more embarrassing things in my lifetime. So, anyway.
Well, after hearing that still impression, I'm not sure that's necessarily true. But there you go. But okay. Well, that's good.
So I would take the seal. If there were no logistics to worry about, I would take the seal. For practical reasons, maybe I'd go with the poppin instead. Although I do worry that he would just like fly away and never come back.
Okay, well yeah, I mean I think if out of all of them I would also take the puffin. Just because I feel like the puffin would be the least maintenance.
True.
You know? And also you don't get the
fish. And this is where we find out that puffins have a seriously like restrictive diet exists within like a very specific mountain region.
Well, I just let him live on the roof or something so he can go and fly and find his own food. And then I just say morning every time I leave the flat and that's it, done.
That's it.
Don't need to do anything else. Brilliant.
It's more like a neighbor than a pet, really, at that point, isn't it?
Yeah, I guess. But you know, that would be my choice. Mm.
Hey, respect, man.
Yeah, your flat would smell of fish if you had the
seals
around everywhere.
But that's the thing. It's like if there were no logistics to worry about, I could just have a swimming pool with a seal in it. I mean, hey, life would be good. It's basically like a sea doggo.
Just pitching you in the summertime, just chilling in your pool with a cocktail, and then the other side of the pool, just chilling is the seal with his cocktail.
That would be badass having a cool a pool party with the seal.
Yeah, and then my puffin flies by every now and then. Is that all right?
Yeah,
that's it.
And it's I love this. We should make this happen in the most responsible way possible. Hey, I'd want to treat my seal good and you know have him live his best life, but. I just imagine him like wearing shades and chilling in that swimming pool. So, guys, if you could choose one of these animals to bring home, which would you choose?
And why? So Alex has gone for the adorable faces of the seals.
Yeah,
I've gone for the low maintenance efforts that the puffin may or may not require because we don't actually know how low maintenance a puffin is.
We're not very well versed in flora and fauna.
No, sadly not. But never mind. It's the thought that counts. Exactly.
And we did think about it. So that's what
matters. A little too much, I think.
You know, that's something I love about doing the Versus series with you, man. It's just like we just go down weird tangents.
And have
a good time.
But it's cool because you get to have a conversation you would never normally have anywhere else. And you know, we certainly wouldn't talk about this in the canteen at work.
Yeah, and I imagine that, you know,
I think
if people at home who are watching this, they get to have some thought-provoking,
enjoy the banter
conversation. Yeah.
I feel like if me and you were talking about taking seals and puffins home at work, you know what I mean? In the canteen, people would be looking at us a little bit funny.
Yeah, or maybe they'd be seriously engaged. Maybe we should start doing that.
Maybe that's, yeah, all right, we'll try it and see what happens.
Yeah. Set up a little a little association.
Little note, Versus has had to be cancelled because Adam and Alex have been, have had a restraining order against seals and puffins.
Before you know it, we just bring in a cage full of seals and puffins and let them loose in the office.
That's it. All right, brilliant. So,
That was fun discussing our evil master plans. Anyway, how are you doing?
That was lucky. All right, I am doing not so bad, but not so great. It depends how much time we've got left, I'm not sure.
Yeah.
I'm not going to tell you my score. You can find out how much you've lost by the end.
All right. I love how the sass that you give me along with that statement. Look, I'm going to tell you. You can find out at the end.
You've won two out of the three already, and I need to take
it
back.
Yeah, I'm going to win the third one as well. So I mean,
I don't believe that.
You might as well. You may as well just tell me now, man, because like, it's not going to matter when you tell me.
Here's what I'll tell you. I've been picking up seemingly a lot of magnets.
Okay.
So
you want to tell me your coinage?
No. I'm hoping that my coinage is already better than what it was in the last round I played. So I'm hoping my coinage is gonna pick me up here and help me win this round. So we'll see.
Well, I mean,
how about you? What's been your
fingers crossed for you,
What's been your most seen power up this level?
I feel like I've had a pretty healthy balance at this point.
Okay.
Yeah, it's been like a well balanced diet of different power-ups.
I've got another magnet.
And I get a jetpack to end it all, round it all off.
Brilliant. Okay, now I just need a jetpack and I think we're safe. I hope. I feel like. I could be wrong. This is the thing. The guys at home are watching. They know the scores right now. Okay, well, if I can't settle for a jetpack, I'll settle for that 2x score multiplier. That's fine.
Sounds good.
Lovely jubbly.
I think I forgot to set the timer.
Oh dear. Well, I'll tell you what. Let's give it.
All right. So I think there's 30 seconds left. All right.
All right. 30 seconds.
All right. I'll count down from 10.
Well saved, sir. Well saved. 30 seconds. And then you recall it. All right.
And 10. Nine,
I love how Alex has strategically eight, decided to start seven, counting down from 10.
Six. Oh, I crashed!
Well, I've got a jetpack. So
So
you're gonna
and
have
I,
to.
And I exited. No.
Well, you're gonna have to. I can't die as a jetpack. You're gonna have to take that one because 4 seconds. Why did you exit on 4 seconds?
I meant to hit the key revive. Oh no!
Well, look, this serves you right.
No.
This serves you right for all the rounds you've been cheating. Right, I'll die straight away. Look, here we go. Bang. There you go. Crash.
Oh no!
Well, I got a new high score as well. Look at that. Fantastic.
Damn. Well, watch as I win this update anyway.
Okay, if you win this update anyway, then I've hats off to you because I did get an extra jetpack there. Right, okay, so guys, I'm pretty happy about this one. Alex shouldn't worry too much because he's already taken Iceland, right?
Uh-huh.
So you've already got that.
All right.
But this is to redeem myself and to hopefully see who if I don't just completely lose Iceland like a complete loser. So,
go ahead.
My coinage was 9,266.
Okay.
What was yours?
9,128.
Really? Oh my god, okay, this is gonna be close. My score was 1,467,450.
My score was 1,365,570 points.
So I think even without that jetpack, I think even without the jetpack, guys, I would have taken
I'm not convinced. I think we're going to need our mathematicians at home.
Well, you can't. All you have to do is go back in the video, find out right at the end point when Alex crashed, look at our two scores and see who had the highest score. I think I took this one. And it's fine by me.
Hey,
I'm happy with the result. Best man won.
Congratulations, Adam.
Thank you, sir. There you go.
You needed this.
We've turned Alex into a slightly better sportsman. There you go.
It just turns out that when you have good karma, at least medium karma, things go better your way. So right. I'm doing my best.
So I win this round. Alex takes Iceland, however. So great job, man.
Thank you.
That's
great. It was a great update.
And guys, don't forget to check out Redbubble. Link is in the description. And go and play with some cool Subway Surfers art of your own design. It'd be really cool.
All right, guys. Thank you so much for watching this week's video. As always, if you enjoyed the video, hit that like button and comment down below who you're rooting for, Team Adam or Team Alex, and get those mathematician brains going, because we want to figure out who actually won this. Even though Adam takes it, you know what, I'm fine with it. You did well, but we do need to figure out the real results.
Thor.
So get to your calculating.
Thor came through for me this time.
Thor came through for you. That's a tongue twister. Get out your calculators and figure that out. And until next time, we will see you guys on the flip side.